Hello students, welcome for today's session. Today's session, we are going to study the Unit 5, Introduction to XML. So before starting with the actual part, first let's try to understand what does XML stand for. XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. SGML, that is Standard Generalized Markup Language, it is a meta markup language which is used for defining a markup language. Markup language is nothing but a language which usually has tags. And this markup language can be used to describe a variety of document types. HTML was developed in the early 1980s. In 1986, HTML was approved by the Indian Standards Organization Standard. HTML was developed using HTML in the early 1990s, specifically for web documents. Now, before starting with XML, first let us try to find out the difficulties or problems with HTML. The first problem was HTML is defined to describe the general form and layout of information without considering its meaning. It is going to just help us to design the layout and how the form should be, but it does not consider any meaning. The second problem with HTML is that it has fixed set of tags and attributes. Given tags must fit every kind of document. No way to find particular information. You have to search the entire document. If you want a specific part of information, you cannot find it immediately. So this was the second problem that was associated with HTML. The third problem was there are no restrictions on arrangement or order of tag appearance in document. There is no particular order that you have to follow when you are using HTML. For example, an opening tag can appear in the content of an element, but its corresponding closing tag can appear after the end of the element in which it is nested. To have a clear understanding, we'll just look at the example given over here. It says strong now, and then we have used one more tag as emphasis is now here strong. So actually, if you go to see this tag, should EM tag should be come here, and then it should be the strong tag. That is what they're trying to say, that there is no restriction on arrangement of the tags, or there is no particular order in which the tags have to be arranged. So these are the problems with HTML. So what is the solution to these problems? So one solution to the first problem is to allow a group of users with common needs to define their own tags and attributes, and then they can use the standard generalized markup language to define a new markup language to meet their needs. Each application area will have its own markup language. We can use HTML to define a new markup language to meet the requirements. So this is one solution to the problem. But the second part is, what is the problem by using HTML? First is, it is going to be very large and complex to use, and it is also very difficult to build a parser for it. HTML includes a large number of capabilities that are only rarely used. Second problem with HTML is that a program capable of HTML documents would be very large and costly to develop. HTML requires that a formal definition be provided with each new markup language. So, having area-specific markup language is a good idea. Having them on HTML is not good. So these are the three problems with HTML. Now, what is the solution? What we can do is we can define a simplified version of HTML and allow users to define their own markup languages based on XML was designed to be that simplified version of HTML. Actually, XML is not going to replace HTML. Both XML and HTML have different goals. HTML is nothing but a markup language which is made of tags used to describe the layout of any kind of information. XML is a meta markup language that is going to provide framework for defining specialized markup languages. So both the things have different goals. Coming to the next part, what are the advantages of using XML? We have understood that XML is good compared to others, but what are the actual advantages of using XML? XML is very simple and universal way of storing and transferring any textual data. Second, XML does not have any predefined tags. You are going to define your own tags according to the meaning and understanding. XML tag and its content together with closing element. XML has no hidden specifications. It is markup language and it is also called as a tag set. The document that uses XML based markup language is called as XML document. Any XML processor is going to be a program that passes XML documents and provides the parts to an application. Both Internet Explorer and Firefox support basic XML. XML is a meta markup language for describing markup languages. It also provides a facility to define tags and structural relationship between the markup languages. So these are the few advantages of XML. What is XML? Stands for Extensible Markup Language. It is similar to HTML. It is designed to carry the data and not to display. Tags are not predefined. You have to define your own tags. XML is designed to be self-descriptive because you are going to define the tags. It is also a W3C recommendation. W3C stands for Worldwide Consortium. XML is not going to be a replacement for HTML. XML is used for carrying your data and HTML is used for designing your data. How the layout should be, what colors should be there, what should be the background. All this is done by HTML. How the data should be, what is the meaning of the data, all those things are going to be done by XML. Next, we are going to study is what is the role of XML in web development? XML is going to play a very important role in the present world of web development. It is perfect for those who wish to make use of web technologies for distributing the information across the web. Like HTML, XML also is being used to format a document with a web browser. XML can be an influential and effective tool to process a document's contents, and therefore creating own tags is possible with the help of XML. XML gels very well with any operating system and it also maintains a great amount of flexibility, which is a very important aspect when we think about web development. The next slide, we are trying to study what are the differences between HTML and XML. So the first difference is related to the abbreviation. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language and XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. HTML is designed to display the data with more focus on how the data looks. But XML is designed to be a software and hardware independent tool which is going to be used to transport and store data with focus on what the data is. HTML is a markup language itself, but XML is going to provide us a framework for defining the markup languages. HTML is a presentation language. XML is not a presentation language, neither a programming language. The next most important difference, HTML is case insensitive and XML is case sensitive. HTML is used for designing a web page to be rendered on the client side. XML is used basically to transport the data between application and the database. HTML has its own predefined tags like the body tag, the bold tag, the italics tag. But in case of XML, you have the choice of flexibility. That is, you can create your own custom tags and that can be defined, and the tags can be invented by the author of the XML document. So it is you who are going to define the tags. So what happens when you define, you need not remember the tags. You know when you name it, you know the meaning of the tag. So that is the amount of flexibility XML allows. The next difference is HTML is not strict if the user does not use the closing tags. So in case you have forgotten to use a closing tag, that's fine. It is not very strict about it. But XML makes it mandatory for the user to close each tag that has been. So this is the most important difference. HTML does not preserve white space. If we want to preserve white space, then we have to use the free tag. But XML preserves the white space. HTML is about displaying data and hence it is static. XML is about carrying data, hence it is dynamic. Static in the sense, once you define, you are not going to change. But XML, because it is going to carry data and data is going to change, it is going to be dynamic in nature. So these are the differences between XML and HTML. So we'll continue in the next session. Thank you, students.